This is Eric from Pack Hacker, and today I'm going to be comparing and contrasting the NOMATIC Navigator Sling and the NOMATIC Navigator Lite Sling. Let's dive in. So starting with the exterior of these two slings, you can see a lot of differences right off the bat. So this is the standard Navigator sling, and then we have the Lite sling on the side here. The main difference between these is their weight. So this is designed to be up to 20% lighter as a part of the Lite family compared to the standard Navigator series, which has a few more features and uses a little bit heavier materials. So this one uses a ballistic nylon exterior, and it just feels very durable. And you can see the texture there of that material. It's just a very nice, thick material. And then we have a 40D nylon with a 330D poly on the Lite sling. So just even when these are both empty, you can really feel a difference of how much lighter this Lite sling is than the standard sling. The standard sling also has this little reflective panel here, so that way if you're out walking at night or something and on the side of the road, you can be seen with this little panel. I don't think that really adds a bunch of weight, but it's definitely something noticeable on the front of this sling. So something else that the standard model has that the Lite model doesn't is these AquaGuard zippers. So this zipper here is an AquaGuard zipper, and this zipper up here is also an AquaGuard zipper, so that'll give you a little bit of extra water resistance. And the Lite sling, as you can see, it just has this one zipper here, and it is not an AquaGuard zipper. Both of these do have semi-locking zippers though, so there's a little mechanism here where you can see the two zipper pulls there, and they just, you stick one end in here, so that way if you try to open it, the other one comes along with it for the ride. And so this one has that as well, but as you can see here, this is a much more flimsy material. It's just like a piece of paracord or something like that, whereas this is like a piece of metal or hard plastic with a wrap around it. So this is more durable, but I haven't had any issues in testing with these paracords. They're just not as durable. So as you can see, we have a very similar harness system here. We've got the exact same YKK buckle on both of these slings. The same strap material, same weight, same everything. We've also got these same strap keepers here, which enable you to get the strap out of your way. It just slides on to the end of the strap here. It's a little hole, and then you can adjust it as you need to get rid of that strap. We also have this little hook here, so you can hang it up on something, or I like to attach a carabiner on there so you can hang it onto things easier. And they both have these little hip huggers here. I do like the material on the standard sling a bit better than I do on the Lite sling. It's just a little bit softer and feels a little bit better, especially if you're wearing like a thin shirt or something like that. But where we start to see changes is on the back panel. So we do have this EVA foam here on the standard sling, and we have these air channels as well, and this is like kind of like a mesh material on the back panel. So this is going to be a bit more breathable than the Lite sling, because the Lite sling just has the same material that we had on the front of the pack, and that's not terribly breathable, and there really isn't any padding in here either. There is like a sheet of some kind of foam in there, but it's very rigid and hard and doesn't have a lot of comfort. I didn't really have an issue with this sling being uncomfortable, but it's definitely not as comfortable as the standard sling. So I have the standard NOMATIC Navigator sling on right now, and as you can see, I'm wearing it in front mode, and that's pretty much the mode that I always wear the Navigator slings in, just because it feels very comfortable to me, especially because of those hip huggers that I mentioned earlier. It just kind of brings the whole sling kind of just feels more natural on your body, and there's not really a gap between you and the sling, which I think is very comfortable. And the added foam, as we just mentioned, does add quite a bit of comfort when you pack this thing out. So I've got the Lite sling on now. And as you can see, it is a little bit boxier when you're wearing it. It's still comfortable to wear on your front, especially because of those hip huggers I'm mentioning again. But it just feels a little bit boxy when you're wearing it. And that's especially true when you have it fully packed, or when you're using the expansion, which we'll go over in a little bit. But overall, very comfortable, but it is lacking that padding that we just mentioned about the standard sling. And you do miss it a little bit when you pack this thing fully out, but still a comfortable carry. So I would say one of the biggest differences for me between these two slings is the inclusion of the zippered pocket on the front, and they actually cut that on the Lite Sling to save space and weight. So if you open up this pocket right now, you can see I have my phone stowed in there and also a cable. So I'll pull my phone out. I'm not gonna pull the cable out because there's actually a cable pass-through in the top corner. I'm not sure how well I can show you that, but that actually runs into the main compartment. So once we get into the main compartment, you'll see that I have a battery bank in there and I have my phone and the cable in the front compartment here. And I think that's an awesome feature because then you don't have to worry about having your phone and your battery bank. And if you wanted to access your phone, you could just pull out your phone and leave it charging just with the cable kind of hanging out. And then when you're done, put it back in there without having to worry about the battery bank coming out too. And just a neat feature overall. I'm gonna pull this out of the way so you can see that there are two pockets in there. It's a little bit hard to see because of the stuff I have stowed in the main compartment, but they're two little elastic pockets and they're pretty small. They only go down, I would say, maybe 2 inches, but it's nice to have that so you can put small items in there or just like little, like even like a dongle or something like that if you needed a dongle for your phone to plug in a microphone or something. Just nice to have a little place to stow small items in a small pocket like this. So moving into the main compartments, I actually have the standard NOMATIC Navigator fully packed right now, and I don't have anything in here, so I can show you how the stuff inside here translates to the Lite Sling. So we'll open this up now. Got to undo the little locking mechanism that I locked earlier and pop this open. So as you can see, we have two pockets on this side. It's that same mesh that was in the front pocket we just went over. I have my wallet in one of them, so it fits a It's a small wallet, but it's pretty bulky because I have my keys in there and stuff too. And then I just have a pair of foldable sunglasses in the other one. So nice mesh pockets here. And then I have my battery bank just sitting in the middle, and that was plugged in to feed through to the front compartment. And that's obviously something you can't do with the Lite Sling. So as you can see, there's not much else going on here. We do have the pen holder here and the key ring right here with a little button. Now let me open the Lite Sling so we can compare the two spaces. So in the Lite Sling, we have those same pockets on the back wall there. Similar size, they actually might be a smidge bigger, but they fit this gear all the same. Slide the wallet into one pocket, and then we also have the sunglasses there. Fits the same, I think they might be a smidge deeper, but that just might be, you know, my eye getting confused. But we do have these two pockets on the opposite side that aren't present on the standard sling. So that's nice to have because you could, you know, throw a bigger item there because these pockets are broken up into, I'd say that's about a 60-40 split. A big pocket takes up 60% and then 40% or maybe even 70-30. And then you do have quite a bit of space in the middle here, so you can still throw a battery bank in there, but you have to have the whole cord in here and then your phone maybe in this pocket over here because you don't have that additional pocket on the front. But one of the biggest draws of this sling is its expandability, and that's where these two slings differ greatly as well. So let me close this up real quick. Close this one too. So on the original NOMATIC Navigator, we have this zipper that runs most of the way around here, and then we have two zippers here. And so this is a whole separate pocket for you to store items, or you could kind of use it as a secret pocket if you wanted to throw your passport in there and then reclose this expansion. But you can throw a lot of different things in here. So I've just got this, let's see what size you are, a 16-ounce water bottle here. You can slide that in there and then close that pocket. So that expansion adds quite a bit of space there. And then you've got your water bottle in the bottom and it's separated away from whatever gear you have here in the main compartment. So that's a nice inclusion, I think, just so you can have your water bottle separated in case it sweats or something like that. But then let me grab that out of there real quick to show you how it would work on the Lite Sling. So we have that same expansion zipper here, but then we don't have any zippers here. So all that did was make the main compartment quite a bit larger. As you can see, it's just like a bit, it goes from 1 liter to 3 liters on both of these slings. So you do have quite a bit more room there. So you could fit something like a water bottle quite a bit more easily and still have room to stack on top of it. but it's not as well integrated, I don't think, because your water bottle is just kind of in the middle of all the rest of your gear, and you don't want your water bottle to like leak on your power bank or your phone or whatever is in there. And obviously not all water bottles leak, but I'm a bit of a worrywart, so I wouldn't even really want to run that risk. And something I'm not a huge fan of about the extension on this one is it's just a little bit awkward. Like, you can see, like, it just is a little bit weird in use sometimes, especially if you don't have a ton of stuff in there. Like, maybe you had a bunch of stuff in there and you took it out and you haven't closed the expansion yet. It's just like a little bit like weird. And this is a very hard shell here, whereas this is not. So I just really think that the expansion is a bit better integrated on the standard sling than it is on the light sling because of that. And it also just basically adds another pocket, and it doesn't just expand the main compartment. So you've really got three pockets on this thing and just the one on this one. So there you have it, a detailed comparison of the NOMATIC Navigator Sling and the NOMATIC Navigator Lite Sling. Thanks for keeping it here at Pack Hacker, your guide to smarter travel. We'll see you in the next one.